PC. Go ahead and just have a seat. We're just glad that you're here. We've got a special night planned together, looking back and also looking ahead. We're so thankful for Reverend Sheila Bates for being here with us to share. We're thankful for Bishop Graves for being with us. Reverend Jeff Wilson, our district superintendent, thank you so much for being here in support of our ministry, and especially your leadership this past week with many churches in our conference were hit hard by Hurricane Michael. And our church has been organizing and coordinating so much disaster relief and response. And we're thankful for your leadership. I wanted to start by just sharing a verse that we come back to often and share. And I think it just captures well the spirit of this evening. This is from 2 Corinthians chapter 9. Apostle Paul writes to the church there, starting in verse 10. The one who supplies seed for planting and bread for eating will supply and multiply your seed and will increase your crop, which is righteousness. You will be made rich in every way so that you can be generous in every way. Such generosity produces thanksgiving to God through us. The ministry of this service to God's people isn't only fully meeting their needs, but it is also multiplying the many expressions of thanksgiving to God. So many in this room have served with us, have supported us financially, have been a part of our mission here. And we're just so thankful for this time to look back, thankful for Lisa and her leadership, her vision. So with that, we want to get started with some interviews. We want to hear from some of the people who've been a part of what we've been doing. And I want to invite Nathan Cox up. Nathan is one of our day camp counselors from 2018 in Tuskegee and is serving with us this semester as well. Just graduated from Auburn in May. So I'm going to ask him to get started with the first round of our interviews.
So we have a couple of our day camp kids here. So, hey guys, I'm celebrating. But we have a few questions for you guys. So, what was your favorite part of day camp this past summer? So, what was our theme this summer? God's masterpiece. So what did that mean for us this summer? What did we emphasize? Arts and craft, music, all that kind of stuff. So what does it mean to you guys to be God's masterpiece? That's good, guys. Well, are there any other things that you guys would like to share about this summer? Any stories that you guys thought were interesting? Okay. Well, thank you guys for coming and for being here with us. We had a really fun summer, and we just really appreciate all the fun that we've had and all the hard work that you guys did this summer. So thank you very much.
Nathan asked the hard questions. At this time, I'd like to invite up one of our home repair families, one of our families we've really got to know so well, and one of our good friends, Miss Andrea McIntosh. Miss Andrea, could you join me? Is Miss Helen Turk here? They're pointing.
She's getting her name.
She's getting her name tag. So, Miss McIntosh. in need of the stool. And we'll get started. And then when Sir gets here, we'll just add her on to this moment of the party. So Ms. McIntosh, I want to just hear, tell us a little bit about yourself, where you're from, and just how you got connected to ARM.
I also from Pennsylvania, which is 30 miles outside of Pittsburgh. I got a call back in 2013, November, that my dad had terminal cancer. And I just packed up and came to Alabama. And when he passed away, he got left the house. So I put my son, let's go and stay in Alabama. We're starting new. Well, when we got back, the pipes had burst and water had went through the kitchen, the den, the powder room. And I was like, Lord, I don't know anybody here, but you're going to help us with this one because I didn't have a clue what to do. And I was looking through some names I saw at Alabama Rural Ministry. So I called and began to make it. She said, well, we have a waiting list. I said, okay, well, you can just put me on there and we'll see what happens. And they did, but it didn't take long as I thought it would. And I told them, I said, you know, my God never makes me wait. I said, they came in and I met the students from different places in Tampa, Florida. It was a group that came, they were magnificent. And we did devotion and one of the young girls told me, she said, Ms. McIntosh, you don't know, you were talking to me about something I had told them. She said, I told God I can't go through this again. And she said, in 1 week, you changed my life. She said, you're so inspiring. She said, I will always love you and keep in touch. And at that point, I thought, you know, if I made a difference in one child's life, I felt my job was done. But if you come find out, they all said, you know, Ms. McIntosh, you inspire me. Ms. McIntosh, can we go there with you? I said, I love you, no.
Tough love, tough love. Well, what's been your favorite part of being a part of the home repair ministry, but then you've also been a part of some of the other ministry that we do?
Yeah, Mr. came and talked to me and said, like, have a problem with day camp. Because I was wondering if you could help us out. And I said, sure, what do I need to do? And he said, well, we're going to be at the school, and you can just help, you know, with the counseling and help the children. Little did I know, it turned into one big happy family. But the kids always, Mom, hurry, we got to get there. Ms. McIntosh, I got to go see Ms. McIntosh. She said, my child won't do that, you know. And I told him, I said, well, listen, I said, go home and do something that your parents didn't ask you to do. I said, go check out the garbage if you see a new thing. There's one gentleman, he said, I had to come and meet you. My son is totally different. I said, well, you know, I try to let the kids know that I support them, I love them, and if whatever they need, if I can do it, I'll do it. So that's the way I took the arm. I said, whatever you need me to do, because they really help me when I need them most. And I love doing what I'm doing. This is my second year with the day camp. And I do other things in between, but I love it, and I will ride that with me together with them for a reason.
One of the other things she does is bakes delicious cookies. So she uses that as a tool at day camp. Some people might call it bribery, but you know, it works. It's effective, and it's just been such a blessing. So 2 summers now, Ms. McIntosh has been a part of our day camp ministry, and I know our day camp counselors have loved having you as part of their team as well. What's been, how have you seen God's presence? How have you experienced God through the whole process?
I'm dealing with several illnesses, and sometimes I can't get up and walk when I want to. I can't do it. But God always gives me the strength to get up and go do something for somebody else. And even if I'm in pain, I put it aside and I go and help. And God has taught me that He's always going to have my back. And that's all I can live on.
So what do you see? This is our 20th anniversary, looking back. But looking ahead, what would be some of your hopes for ARM's next 20 years?
that they grow and go into other parts, cities and places, and let them know that there's always a way. You know, if you got a problem and they can help you, they will. And I can help you too. All the better.
Thank you, Ms. McIntosh. Do we have Ms. Helen Turk? Would you mind joining us? So glad you're here, Ms. Turk. Ms. Turk, can you just give us a quick introduction? Tell us where you're from and how you got connected with ARM.
My name is Helen Turk. I'm from Noblesville, a little city down the road. And thank God you all helped my sister and then with her house. And so I had kept asking her. So all of a sudden one day, y'all came by and left a number for me to call you all. So it's just been a wonderful experience. Awesome, everything.
Yes, ma'am. So what's been your favorite part of that?
Meeting all the volunteers that came to my house now. They don't care what color you are, what religion, or whatever. They just like their family. Just come right on in.
I know you do. You show a lot of hospitality when the volunteers are there. During the summer, I remember hearing at the end of the week, all our teams will share about what's been the favorite part of their experience with us. And the team that goes to your house always talked about the pizza, the chicken wings, and all the other teams, all the other crew looked around like, you never told us this. Y'all are getting fed like that.
That's the least I can do with all they do. They don't want to let me pick up a broom.
we tell them to let you help, but I guess they just... Well, how have you seen, how have you experienced God? How have you seen God's presence?
I see God's presence and all the people that come around and help me because it wasn't for him. Y'all won't be there and I'm going to be there. And then thank God for the way they did my house. From the top down to the bottom. I had dreamed about my house was raining in there. So nothing was raining in there. I said, Lord, mercy, dream come true. So I didn't know that my house was really raining in there. One day it rained. I said, you can go down and see what the problem is. And so my brain was coming through the ceiling of my house, but now I don't because y'all fix it. Thank God.
What kind of impact has that had on your life and your family's life even?
Yes, very. We've seen how other people help other people. Make you feel like God put everybody who she is. Just what you do have that.
Well, so I asked Miss Andrea, I want to ask you as well, what would you be some of your hopes, or as you look for ahead for ARM, what would you like to see ARM doing in the next 20 years?
In the next 20 years, I don't know what else I can add. You don't know.
That's a good point. Thank you so much, Ms. Turk. Well, I think we've come to the point now where we want to serve some dinner. And as we do that, I just wanted to say thank you to Reverend Chris Kelsey, who will be playing some music in the background for us. Thank you. Thank you, Chris, for doing that. And I want to invite Reverend Jeff Wilson, our district superintendent, to come and share a blessing.
Let's pray together. Holy God, we give you thanks and praise for this time to gather together to celebrate your work through the Alabama Rural Ministry. God, we thank you for those who have led and served, for teams that have come from near and far. God, we thank you for the partners and for lives that have been changed as relationships have been planted and grown. God, we thank you for your work and for the opportunity to be part of it. We thank you for this food, for those that have prepared it and those who now prepare to serve us. May we be strengthened for ministry. May we be strengthened for faithful living. May we be strengthened to go forth into your world in the name of the risen Christ. For we gather, we pray, we live, we have all of our life in his name. Amen.
I may have spoken a little too soon. Looks like our food's still being brought out to be served. So we're going to start a slideshow that starts, I don't think it starts in 98, but I think it starts in about 2001, 2002. So it's a lot of pictures for you to enjoy just some glimpses of our ministry over the past. And then as soon as the food is out and ready, I will let you know and we'll get started. How about that? Awesome. Thank you. So our meal is ready. It's buffet style, so you've got two, you can serve your plates from both sides of the table. So please, at this time, feel free to enjoy yourself. Time of fellowship and great food. So someone get us started. Yeah.